proposing the notion that belief in God is reasonable is an internationally renowned philosopher and theologian.
We have a UK speaking tour which is being planned for October of 2011.
And he's going to be debating Polly Toynbee, the noted journalist and a critic of religion, and of course president of the British Humanist Association. So that's a fantastic way to get the tour off to a great start. And I'm pleased to tell you that we have now opened the ticket lines. You can actually book and buy your tickets for the tour. It's not just the London date.
Academic forums where one concentrates on the arguments and counter-arguments, the truth of the premises of those arguments and objections to them, and not on personalities or ad hominem attacks.
This has come as a shock to me, especially after we've obviously advertised and sold tickets for the tour. I don't often give my personal opinion, as it were, my subjective opinion on individuals, but I have to say I am disappointed in Polly Toynbee. If you could go onto the website of the British Humanist Association, one of their core values they describe as engaging in debate rationally, intelligently, and with attention to evidence. And that's really all we were asking her to do. I don't know, perhaps following the cue of her fellow vice presidents of the British Humanist Association, Richard Dawkins and AC Grayling, who of course have both resolutely refused to debate Bill when he comes over to the UK.
Rather pity these people. They react in a way that sounds defensive and actually really rather pathetic.
So what? If something is true, then it's true. And no amount of prattling about it being bleak and uncomfortable will make it any different from that.
You cannot argue for some truth about the universe by saying that it would be nice if it were true.
Not just a matter of not wanting to be involved in a rhetorical debating situation. He's been completely unresponsive.
It's not every day that one atheist accuses another of cowardice for refusing to debate a Christian. It's even rarer when both are Oxford dons.
That would look great on your CV, not so good on mine.
In a letter to Professor Dawkins, Dr. Kame said, "The absence of a debate with the foremost apologist for Christian theism is a glaring omission on your CV, and is, of course, apt to be interpreted as cowardice on your part." I was somewhat amused at his comment about my relentless drive for self-promotion. The fact is that I haven't sought to have this debate. This has been set up by these independent groups. This has been nothing to do with my...
We'll be right back.
What they plan to do at the Sheldonian Theater in Oxford is set up the stage for a debate format with an empty table, an empty chair, where Dawkins will be given the opportunity to the last minute to show up. If he doesn't, then I'll simply give a lecture criticizing his arguments in the God delusion against the existence of God.
We'll have a friendly conversation about it, and I'll win the argument.
We really wanted to have both Richard Dawkins and A.C. Grayling to have some kind of a debate with William Lane Craig. They've both refused, and they've given a number of reasons. One of the reasons that A.C. Grayling gave was that he said, "I'm not interested in debating Professor Craig. That's for the very uninteresting matter of whether there is just one god or goddess, and that it can be debated. Well, that's an empty prospect, hence my declining the invitation." Well, that was disappointing, obviously, that A.C. Grayling, who is one of the foremost philosophical atheists in the country, wasn't prepared to get into a debate on the existence of God.
The topic we're talking about is what it would take to convince us of the existence of the supernatural. Now, as a scientist, I've always been very willing to say something like this. Of course I'm open-minded. It only takes somebody to come along and show me the evidence for the existence of a supernatural God, and I would immediately announce my conversion.
On the Feast of the Epiphany today, three wise people attended a temporary shelter. No gold, frankincense and myrrh here. Just the authors, A.C. Grayling, Polly Toynbee, and Richard Dawkins. They were here to launch the Atheist Bus campaign, sponsored in part by the British Humanist Association.
I rather like it upbeat.
I agree with you.
It's
funny, and it gets people to talk about it.
It was strange then to read later on him being quoted on the Richard Dawkins website, and Dawkins quoted Grayling as saying, "Craig claims to have debated me before. That is not correct, unless you count a brief exchange of emails." Now, the strange thing about all this is that it's actually Grayling who's mistaken there. They did have a debate, and in fact, we're going to be hearing it today.
Please welcome Professor A.C. Grayling.
They had a debate in 2005, no less at the Oxford Union, of all places. So quite a significant date to have slipped in the memory of A.C. Grayling.
In a provocative way,
the problem that traditionally philosophers have called the problem of evil.
It would seem that that intelligent and interested agency in the universe would have to be either malevolent or, if not impotent, then only quasi-potent.
But to say that is to assume precisely those two hidden assumptions. And so if the response is not to be question-begging, we need to see some argument on behalf of
now, those. Now, both those points were made by Professor Craig in his presentation, and he was talking about the hidden assumptions made by the person who doesn't believe in fairies and so on.
Thank you, Professor Grayling, for those interesting remarks.
I can tell you that my brothers and sisters and co-thinkers in the unbelieving community take him very seriously. He's thought it was a very tough guy, very rigorous, very scholarly, very formidable. I say that without reserve. I don't say it because I'm here. Normally I don't get people saying, good luck tonight, you know, kind of thing, and don't let us down, you know. But with him I do.
The one Christian apologist who seems to have put the fear of God into many of my fellow atheists.
Both sides of an argument are given a level playing field, and the other person is called to account for his views and how he would respond to objections to those views. Giving a lecture and answering audience questions doesn't call a speaker onto the carpet in that way that a debate format does.
Academic forums.
Well, I hope we have a good discussion.
You won't want to miss what promises to be a fantastic tour. It's all happening from Monday the 17th of October.